गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे इट इज़ आवर 18th लेक्चर ऑफ बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज ज़ीनर डायोड. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द पी एन जंक्शन डायोड, बेसिक डायोड. नाउ टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ज़ीनर डायोड. सो एज यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम, द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ज़ीनर डायोड इज वेरी मच सेम एज अ पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. It has p-type terminal, it has n-type terminal. Both p and n-type terminals are connected together. Electrons and holes crossing takes place. Depletion region is formed. So similar to p-n junction diode, Zener diode also has p-type material, n-type material and depletion region. So what is the main difference between p-n junction diode and Zener diode? P-n junction diode works normally in forward bias. In reverse bias, very less current flows, and after breakdown voltage, large current flows. This is the working principle of PN junction diode. But the Zener diode is manufactured in a such a way that the reverse breakdown voltage of Zener breakdown is adjusted between 3 volt to 200 volt. See the difference. P-n junction diode in reverse bias condition, there is no as such specification that it will break down at 10 volt, sorry, minus 10 volt, minus 20 volt, minus 100 volt, minus 500 volt. There is no as such specification. But Zener diode can be manufactured at a particular reverse breakdown voltage. This is the main feature of Zener diode with respect to P-n junction diode, that its reverse breakdown voltage is adjusted. And as I explained in previous lecture also, that when PN junction diode is operated in reverse bias condition and when the breakdown takes place in reverse bias condition, the PN junction diode gets damaged. But Zener diode, when breakdown takes place, it does not get damaged. This is the main difference. PN junction diode after breakdown damages. You have to replace it in the circuit with new PN junction diode. But in Zener diode, when that breakdown occurs, it does not get damaged. Again, you decrease the voltage, means when voltage increased, breakdown takes place. Again, you decrease the input voltage, diode gets recovered. Zener diode gets recovered. There is no need of replacement. This is the major difference between PN junction diode and Zener diode. So, hence, Zener diode is also called as a breakdown diode because it is used in only breakdown condition. The application of Zener diode is only in breakdown condition. Circuit madhe asha tikani use karatat ki jithe tyacha breakdown cha use karaycha asel. And we know that the Zener breakdown is adjusted between 3 volt to 200 volt. So it can break down at particular 5 volt. If you go into the market, you can ask the shopkeeper to sell you the Zener diode of 5 volt breakdown voltage, 10 volt breakdown voltage. Means you can say that specific breakdown voltage you will say to the shopkeeper, and then he'll sell you the Zener diode with particular breakdown voltage. If you want in circuit that Zener breakdown should get breakdown at particular 25 volt, give me that kind of Zener diode, then he'll give you that kind of Zener diode. Okay, so similar to PN junction diode, Zener diode can also work in forward bias as well as reverse bias. In forward biasing, the Zener diode works very similar to PN junction diode. Zener works very similar to PN junction diode. Okay, so it means that Zener diode is exactly same as PN junction diode in forward bias condition. In forward bias condition, what is the case? P-type material connected to positive terminal, N-type material connected to negative terminal, and hence when you increase the voltage, input voltage when increased, the depletion region width goes on decreasing. At particular voltage, the depletion region vanishes and current starts flowing, and that voltage is called as cut-in voltage. For silicon it is 0.6, for germanium it is 0.2. Getting? So same kind of working is there for Zener diode also. Getting? So Working of Zener diode is similar to PN junction diode in case of forward biasing, means P2P end-to-end connection. See, the forward biasing of diode is already shown in the circuit here. Getting? And below it is reverse bias circuiting. Okay, see the symbol of Zener diode. See, the zigzag line is there. In case of normal diode, the line was like this. So this is normal diode, and this which is encircled with the red line, it is Zener diode. See the symbol difference. Z, you can see the vertical Z over there. Getting? So it is a Zener diode, symbol of Zener diode. So here the second B diagram is the forward biasing of Zener diode. Diagram C is your reverse biasing of Zener diode. Getting? So it is very simple. Now we'll see the working of VI characteristic. See, this is the forward VI characteristic of Zener diode. As you can see, this diagram is exactly same to the VI characteristic of PN junction diode. Getting? Forward voltage VF is there, reverse current, forward current IF is there. So after cutting voltage, current starts flowing through the diode. So the working principle of Zener diode is exactly same to the working principle of PN junction diode in case of forward biasing only. Only forward biasing. Okay, so this is the VI characteristic of Zener diode in case of forward biasing. Getting? After cut-in voltage, when you increase the voltage, the current starts flowing through the diode, otherwise current will not flow if the voltage is below cut-in voltage. And in reverse biasing of Zener diode, when a p-type material connected to negative terminal, n-type material is connected to positive terminal, then this kind of connection is known as reverse biasing of Zener diode. The operation of Zener diode in reverse bias condition is substantially different from the normal PN junction diode. So in reverse biasing of Zener diode, the as we increase the voltage, very small saturation current in microampere flow through the diode. This current flows due to thermally generated electrons. Okay, so at certain voltage, the reverse current will increase rapidly and sharply, and that condition is, we call it as a breakdown condition. So at breakdown condition, Zener diode carries a large current. Okay, but that breakdown is different than your PN junction breakdown. See in this diagram, as you can see, this is your first quadrant, that is your forward biasing of Zener diode. This is third quadrant, that is your reverse biasing of Zener diode. But see this, at this Zener voltage, a large current is flowing through the diode. Getting? And that current flow is increased in very sharp manner. See, the direct vertical line is there. But in case of normal PN junction diode, how was the graph? See, I am drawing the yellow graph, which stands for normal PN junction diode. See, this yellow line indicates the graph of reverse VI characteristic for normal PN junction diode. And see, the dark black line is for Zener diode. See the major difference between working of reverse biasing of Zener diode and reverse biasing of PN junction diode. As the process is avalanche breakdown, that's why that process is cumulative. Donche electrons 4 honar, 4 che 8 honar, 8 che 16, 16 che 32, 32 che 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024. Asha paddhatine electrons he cumulative vadnare. So the graph is somewhat like this, the yellow line. Getting? After breakdown, okay, but in Zener, as soon as breakdown takes place, the large current flows, very large current flows through it. Getting? So this is the main difference between reverse biasing of Zener diode and reverse biasing of PN junction diode. After breakdown has occurred, the voltage across Zener diode remains constant. It is not changing. So in case of PN junction diode, see the dotted line I have drawn. See, there is a change in reverse voltage. Means if you increase somewhat voltage, then your current will increase in case of PN junction diode. But in case of Zener diode, the voltage is constant at VZ. That is what I am telling you, that if you go into the market, if you purchase Zener diode for 5 volt, then it will break down at 5 volt. Its voltage across diode will not increase. It will remain 5 volt and still the current value will increase. Still current value will increase. See this current for Zener diode, I am using the red marks. See, voltage is constant, but still current is increased. This is because of we are using Zener diode and it is specially designed for that. That you are using at a particular reverse breakdown voltage. So whatever this shaded part is there, see this shaded part, whatever this shaded part is there, that is called as a Zener region. So in Zener region, the voltage across Zener diode remains constant, but the current changes depending upon the input voltage. So input voltage increases, output voltage remains constant, but current through the diode in reverse condition increases sharply. The word sharply is very important. Getting? So Zener diode is operated in this region when it is used as a voltage regulator. So one question is always asked in the paper, what is the use of Zener diode as a voltage regulator? So when the input voltage of regulator increases, the output voltage remains constant, current through the diode increases. Getting? So this is your Zener diode complete VI characteristic. Zener diode complete VI characteristic. Getting? Any doubt in this? Okay, now we'll study the circuit connection of forward biasing and reverse biasing. See, by using this, we can calculate the VI characteristic of diode. See, for forward, see the connection. P-type material, that is triangle part, is connected to positive terminal, and that vertical line is connected to the negative terminal. So in diagram A, it is P2P end-to-end connection. So it is forward biasing. In second diagram B, the N-type material connected to positive terminal, triangular part is connected to negative terminal. So it is reverse biasing connection. Okay. And we have already seen the complete VI characteristic of Zener diode. I have already shown you the difference between the both complete VI characteristic. In forward biasing, the working, the graph of VI characteristic is same. I am using the word same in forward biasing. In reverse biasing, the working is slightly different, as well as the VI characteristic is also slightly different. In PN junction diode, the VI characteristic is increasing with some curve, but in Zener diode, the reverse current is increasing sharply after breakdown. This is the major difference. Okay. So similar to PN junction diode, here also in reverse bias condition, breakdown is occurring. Getting? So in Zener diode also, there are two types of breakdown. One is called avalanche breakdown and one is called Zener breakdown. Avalanche breakdown, we have already studied that electron moves with high kinetic energy. It collides with one silicon atom. Hence, kinetic energy decreases. This energy is absorbed by silicon atom. This energy cannot be sustained. Hence, one electron, free electron is emitted by the silicon atom. So, two electrons are becomes free. So, both electron moves with same kinetic energy. Again, collides with two silicon atom. Two more new electrons are generated. So, out of from two, the four electrons are generated. From four, eight electrons will be generated. From eight, 16, 16 to 32, 32 to 64. Then 128. Likewise, the electrons quantity will increase suddenly, and this is a cumulative process that is called as an avalanche breakdown. Okay, and same breakdown takes place in Zener diode also. Okay, along with this avalanche breakdown, one Zener breakdown also taking place. Zener breakdown, because of that Zener breakdown, the sharp current, sharp reverse current is there. Okay, so how it takes place? See, Zener diode observed that it is having reverse breakdown, suppose at 5 volt. Okay, so when reverse voltage of 5 volt is applied to Zener diode, very intense electric field is appearing across the depletion region. Means whatever depletion region reverse breakdown has, when this 5 volt is applied, suppose ekhada diode ghetla jyacha reverse breakdown 5 volt ahe. ओके असा डायोड घेतल्यानंतर त्याला जर तुम्ही रिवर्स ब्रेकडाउन व्होल्टेज दिले 5 व्होल्ट व्हाट विल हॅपन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रिवर्स ब्रेकडाउन व्होल्टेज व्हेरी इंटेंस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अपीयर्ड अक्रॉस द नॅरो डिप्लिशन रीजन दिस इंटेंस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज स्ट्रॉंग इनफ टू सम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड is strong enough to pull some of the valence electrons into the conduction band by breaking their covalent bonds. These electrons then become free and becomes available free for the conduction. Okay, so large number of electrons will constitute large reverse current through the Zener diode, and breakdown is said to be occurred, and this is called as a Zener breakdown. Means what? We are applying the reverse voltage. Because of that reverse voltage, large electric field is applied across the depletion region. Because of this large electric field, intense electric field, the covalent bonds of all silicon atom breaks suddenly. I am saying suddenly. So because of this sudden breakdown, all the electrons which are present in covalent bond becomes free to move. Means khup tumhi reverse voltage apply kela, त्याच्यामुळे त्या कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड्सवर खूप प्रेशर एक्झर्ट होतं, कारण की ती इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड स्ट्रॉंग आहे. ओके, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस स्ट्रॉंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अक्रॉस कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड, सगळे कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड काय होतात, रप्चर होतात, ब्रेक होतात. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ब्रेकिंग ऑफ कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड, एक कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड ब्रेक झाला म्हणजे दोन इलेक्ट्रॉन तयार होतात. असे सगळे कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड ब्रेक झाल्यामुळे ऍट अ टाइम, म्हणजे सुरुवातीला काहीच इलेक्ट्रॉन नव्हते, अचानक सगळे इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री झाले. सो सडनली लार्ज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स गेट्स फ्री, and this large electron constitutes large reverse current through the Zener diode, and this is called as a Zener effect. That's why this breakdown is called as a Zener breakdown. Okay, so these two types of breakdown takes place in Zener diode. So this is it, this is it, that breakdown of Zener diode. Getting? So it is very simple. Zener diode, only difference is there in reverse bias condition.